ain't easy, no. So I surrender my ego. And I'm feeling no. I'm ready for my class up, Mr. Devil. Hey, how everybody doing today? They're probably saying, man, he released another vlog. What? Yes, another vlog. This will be vlog 93, Life After Second Life. Life After Second Life. I'm going to tell you the confines of Second Life and like what it's about and what it is, starting from the beginning. What Second Life is something what The Sims should be. Except you're playing online with actual people online. You know, it's excellent, beautiful, wonderful game. You know, you get to meet people around the world, but it's like, it's so much other stuff behind it, you know? Of course, you're having fun. You make plenty of money. Like, it's quite a few millionaires that have made money, like, just by playing the game. But the reason why I stopped, and I shout out to Sia and Stash, you know, they my sisters for life. You know, I've just known, only to get to know them for like a few days or so. And, you know, they as real as they come, you know, and I'm truly and extremely grateful for them. You know, like I said, when I say they my sisters for life, they can call or text me and say, yo, Drew, I need this or that. And I'll be like, I got you. Say this, I got you. But it's like, it's so much fun you can have, but it's so much like other stuff that can happen, like with, you know, drama and stuff like that. And it also like stuff, it's like also stuff you could get away with that you normally wouldn't be able to get away with in real life, you know? And that was like running amok on there. It's like before I started playing Second Life, it's like I had, my life was normal. I spent a lot of time with God, you know? I love God like no other. Without God, I'm nothing. I'm nothing without Jesus, literally. And you know, I was exercising a lot more before playing that game. Like my social skills was intact. But it's like, the moment I started playing Second Life, it's like, it became an addiction and had me so hooked that to the point to where I was losing focus. I wasn't spending like a lot of time with God like I needed to. What else I wasn't doing? I wasn't exercising. I was exercising, but not as much. I was also being deprived of sleep. Like I wouldn't go to bed till like 1 or 2 or sometimes 3 in the morning. And you know, it was literally taking like all of my life away, you know, just by playing that game. And one thing my brother Tyrell told me, like back when he first told me about the game, he said the game would steal your soul. And he was like joking about it, but he was being dead serious. The game will literally steal your soul away from you. Like if you just getting on that game to have fun and stuff, then that game is not for you. It's not. I'm gonna be honest with you. That game is like the devil's playground, like literally. And it's like, because there's so much stuff you can do and so much stuff you can get away with that you won't get away with in real life. You know what I mean? And you have to be careful and be mindful of what are you doing. But like, I commend everybody that gets on there not only to have fun, but also have a business, have their business mentality to make money from there. You know, I commend all of them. Like you, if you play it like that, then yeah, you could play the game. But if you're not playing the game like that, you don't need to be playing the game. Another thing, if you are in a relationship, I feel you should not be playing that game, because from what I've heard stories to where couples have been broken up due to people not spending enough time together. You know, you're not spending enough time together with your significant other. Or like you sneaking around behind their back while playing their game, you know. And like it's an addiction, man. It truly is a drug addiction. Like, let me tell you, it's like smoking. Same thing as smoking a cigarette for the first week, but you can't pull away from the cigarettes because now you're hooked on the cigarettes. It's hard to pull your weight. But during that whole time I was playing the game, I was asking God, please help me pull away from this game, because I want to spend more time with Him. I want my normal life back. And you know, and He put these two beautiful, strong black women in my corner. Like, because at first, like, I added them because I was like, you know, they look attractive. I just wanted to add them as friends. And, you know, one of them said, like, I think he should be our brother. And I think that was Seal, you know. But, like, shout out to both of them. You know, they is really they get, you know, and, like, the conversation we has between me and them, like, I iron out the details. They really don't know why I live, but I'm going to let them know why I live. But I'm not going to discuss it in the video. But shout out to them. I'm so grateful that, you know, God put them in my corner, because now I feel like weights have been lifting off my shoulders. I can leave the game with my life intact, you know. But it's so much going on. It's like you get hooked, literally. You know, when you see druggies out on the corner, out on the street, they need more of that fix, that quick fix. Second Life is like that quick fix. Like, you, it's hard to pull away from that game. You know, let me tell you, it's truly hard to pull away from that game. So now, I'm at a point now where I can pull away from the game. Other game, thank goodness, you know. I can actually pull away from the game. I have no regrets or worries about pulling away from the game. It only took me like 2 months and some change to pull away. Let me tell you. I've talked to Tyrell, my bro, and he told me it took him several years before he pulled away from that game. And, like, that game is fun, but I feel like it's only for certain people. I just know it's not for me, because I love God more than anything. I like spending time with God. You know I could not spend time with God if I keep playing that game the way I play it. So I'm so grateful and blessed, but for the people that, you know, just, you know, want to have a good time, like, go right ahead, but don't let it be such an addiction to the point it would be hard for you to pull away from the game. Because I'm going to tell you now, when you first play that game, it's going to be hard for you to pull away. It's going to be extremely hard for you to pull away. And now that I'm pulling away now I feel more better. My mind feel more clear now. I feel more understanding. And understand that, you know, they, Stas and Sia, are the only ones, like, I trust them so much. They the only ones that got my phone number. Don't nobody have my phone number in that game. Nobody. Oh, they the only two that got my number. So I trust them with everything, you know. They my sisters for life. Whatever they need, I got their back no matter what. But I was seeing so much scrutiny and backstabbing going on. But not just for me, because I was running amok. I'm going to tell you. Like, I was doing a lot of stuff, you know. Doing some crazy off-the-wall stuff. But it's like when you have conversations with people, it's like they talk about another person behind their back. And, like, I was seeing it. But mind you, this was way before I met Sia and Stas. Like, I was in a family, and within the confines of the family, like, I used to have conversations with one of them, and they always talk about, like, my best friend behind their back. And they always would say to me, like, you know, keep this conversation between us. Don't let her know about it. Like, I kept hearing it. And even before I even joined their family, like, stuff like that was going on the beach. It was stuff, people that was talking behind her back on the beach. And it's like, I was seeing it, I was hearing it. But, you know, me being me, if you tell me to keep a secret, I'm not going to tell anybody. You know, it's like a secret is kept with me. You know, I'm not going to betray their trust. But it's kind of wrong how it is. But just know that I'm not going to get into any details of that, because I'm no longer on that game no more. You know, thank goodness. You know, I thank God above, you know, for pulling me away from that game, because that game is literally the devil's playground, let me tell you. But, like, I want my normal life back, you know, which I'm finna start back doing. I'm finna start back working out more, spending more time with God, you know, making my YouTube videos besides the vlogs, because I make vlogs, trailer reaction videos, gameplay videos. I can get back to that again. Like, I used to not do that. I've been literally lazy and slacking due to playing Second Life. You know, I wasn't making many videos like I should be making them. So now I can truly make the videos that I need to make and understand it. What you see behind me now is probably some Second Life footage, but this is Second Life, what you see behind me. But I just want y'all to know, man, just like, if you know you real close with God, or you have a relationship with somebody, don't go in that game. Do not go in that game. It's like a mental and emotional distraction. And trust me, man, that game will distract you. If you're not getting on that game to make money, don't go on that game. Do not go on that game if you're not going to get on there to make money. But, yeah, that game is for some people, then it's not for some people, you know. But some people, they probably get on it to, you know, as a distraction from their real life. Me, I was just using it as, you know, just to see what the confines of the game is, what everything it has to offer, which I've pretty much seen enough because, like I said, you know, I'm getting back to my normal life now. The way I miss my normal life, I'm not going to even lie, you know. And they, like, my sisters that are now my sisters now on that game, it's like they the only ones that set me down and talked to me when nobody doing it. It's like I was looking for that, you know, and, you know, I was looking for that way out, like, to get me out of that game. And it took them to giving me the best advice that they humanly possibly can, you know, and kudos to them. And I thank them and love them for that, you know. But I'm, like I said, I'm getting back to my normal life. I will be doing more gameplay videos, more trailer reaction videos. I will be doing more of this stuff. So y'all will be seeing more of that besides the vlogs, because I know y'all be like saying, don't he got some more videos to do besides that? Oh yeah, my funny videos too. I need to start doing more funny videos. I ain't been doing that much either. So yeah, y'all gonna get a lot from me. Just know and understand it. And I won't let each and every last one of y'all, I love every last one of y'all. You know, make sure you like, share the video, comment, subscribe. Don't forget to hit that notification bell on all up-to-date entertainment, gaming, video vlog news, you name it. I'll bring it to all you want from you people around the world. So, till then, man, y'all take it easy. And don't forget to get right with Jesus. Peace. I'm out. Could it if I gain all the world, but I lose it?